This is Amy Chapman. This is her 12th puppy, and this is Pilaf.
Welcome to Growing Up Guide Pup. This week we traveled down to Los Angeles to attend the LA Web Fest. Now, as much as we wanted to bring Pilaf with us, she wasn't quite ready for a trip this big, so we brought her half-brother Andretti with us instead. The whole point about going down the LA Web Fest was that we were screening our show. And, well, Pilaf's the star of the show, so why wouldn't we bring her? Well, the hotel that the screening was at was right across the way from LAX. There's a lot of planes taking off and landing, and it's pretty noisy. Not only that, we were right next to the road that leads right into LAX, so there's a lot of traffic of cars, buses, and basically, it's very busy. Now, we know that Pilaf gets overwhelmed very easily, and even though she's making huge progress, we really didn't want to take any back steps by taking her to an outing that she wasn't quite ready for. And also, the relieving situation at the hotel might have been a little bit difficult for Pilaf. But on the flip side, we really wanted to take a puppy down to represent the show and guide dogs. Andretti's already 10 months old and has proven he can handle trips with his razor, so we asked if we could borrow Andretti. When we checked in, our hotel room was all the way up on the 9th floor, so traveling down the elevator 9 flights and then walking through the lobby to go out to go to the bathroom is a pretty long trip first thing in the morning. But Andretti had no problem with this. He was amazing with his relieving habits and had no trouble whatsoever. While we were in LA, Matt really wanted to go eat at Pink's, the famous hot dog diner in Hollywood. So we hopped in the car to get there. As we drove past, we were shocked to see the line was all the way around the corner. So we decided to go ahead and bear the line and try these famous hot dogs out. Andretti was super patient while we waited in line because it's really nothing but taking a few steps and then walking and waiting and then repeating. Over an hour later, we finally sat down at a table. We had no problem sitting down and enjoying our meal without being disturbed by Andretti trying to get up and move around. He laid very patiently under the table and allowed us to eat our meal. Even when a French fry dropped on the ground right next to him, he didn't budge. He totally ignored it and pretended it wasn't even there. Now, I know he knew it was there, but a guide dog cannot go after any food, and Andretti was fabulous at this.
Okay.
One of the challenges we face with traveling with our guide dog puppies is exercise. Being cooped up in a hotel room doesn't give you a lot of opportunity to get out and about and exercise. So one of the things we can do in our hotel room is play tug. After we got back from Pink's, this is exactly what we did. One of the most important events of the entire trip was to attend our screening. Now, attending our screening is basically like attending a movie. The room is dark and quiet, and people are enjoying what's on the screen. So Andretti's job is to lay quietly and not make any noise so people around him aren't disturbed. And he was fabulous at this. He walked right in the room and laid down and really didn't budge until it was time for us to get up and go. We're super excited to announce that Growing Up Guide Pup came back with awards in editing, directing, outstanding host, and outstanding documentary series. So the next day after our awards ceremony, we had an opportunity to meet up with one of our biggest fans, Christy and her service dog, Windsor. Now, we did want to shoot some of this, but because of her injuries, she has a problem with EMFs, electronic magnetic forces. So we had to use her camera that's already been measured that puts out low EMFs. When we met up with Christy and Windsor, she was really excited to show us around her neighborhood and show off some of the skills that Windsor does for her. Windsor is a golden retriever and about 4 years old, and he is an incredible dog. Raising awareness of what Windsor does for Christy was really important to her. Now, Christy several years ago was involved in a really bad car accident and suffered some pretty traumatic brain injuries. But the way she's handled it is truly inspiring. Christy was very gung-ho about us filming with her. She had no problem with us showing anything that Windsor does for her or anything that might have happened along our walk. When a garbage truck drove by, it was really loud and probably put off a lot of EMFs. And it did cause Christy to go into what she calls one of her episodes. Windsor jumped right into action. He seemed to alert her that she was about to go into one of these episodes and stood in front of her so she couldn't walk forward anymore. He was there right by her side as she passed through her episode and then was able to help Christy back up. Windsor is an all-around service dog. This is the first time we got a chance to meet a dog like him. Not only is he a medical alert dog, where he can sense Christy's episodes before they happen, he's also her mobility dog, where if she loses balance, she is able to use him and push off on him, where he braces and supports part of her weight. Not only that, she has trouble getting up and down curbs, so once again, she can use Windsor to brace herself and use him to balance. After Christy's episode passed, she wanted to show us what Windsor does for her at the grocery store. So away we went. Because Christy sometimes has some balance issues, it can be difficult for her to separate the parts. So she comes prepared in Windsor's little pack. She has a little tug thing that she puts onto the cart, and Windsor will pull the cart out for her. Another cool trick is that Windsor actually does shopping. Now, Christy has a hard time bending over and picking things off the lower shelves. So Windsor does it for her. Christy can point to objects she wants, and Windsor will pick them up. Christy pointed out some cotton balls for Windsor to pick up, and he grabbed them and placed them into the cart. He also grabbed soap and placed it into the cart, and he also grabbed some nail polish remover, which kept falling through the cart, but he was still really resilient and wanted to get that nail polish remover in the cart, so he kept working at it until it was placed safely in the cart.
Give it to me. Bring it. You're gonna get it on your basket. Okay, yeah, you tell it to stay there.
Good job.
One of the last things that Windsor got for Christy was some carrots. Now, I don't know about everybody else out there, but I know my dogs, if you told them to pick up some carrots, they'd eat them. Windsor not only didn't eat the carrots, he picked them up gently and placed them into the cart without taking a second look at them. One of my favorite parts was watching Windsor check out. Windsor hands the clerk Christy's credit card so she can pay, and then takes the credit card back and hands it back to Christy, and then we're on our way. On the way home from the grocery store, we saw Windsor multitask. Not only did he help carry the groceries, check for traffic when we were crossing the street, but also help Christy on and off the curbs, just like a guide dog. Windsor has to be one of the most impressive service dogs Matt and I have ever seen. It's service dog teams like Christy and Windsor that really inspire Matt and I to continue to raise puppies. We get asked the question all the time, isn't it difficult to give them up? And the answer is yes, it is. But when you see a working dog team in action, it really makes it worthwhile, and we really enjoy doing it. So we want to send a huge thank you out to the LA Webfest, Andretti's Puppy Raisers, Robin and Warren, and of course, Christy and Windsor, because this episode really turned out fantastic, and we couldn't have done it without you. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Growing Up Guide Pup.